Hi my friends, how you all doing? Welcome back to the channel and welcome to another episode of FM19's The Hall of Famer. And we are going to continue with our time here at Montpellier. If you missed last episode, you don't know anything about that, but we're now in charge of Montpellier in France. It's above right now though, my friends. Do go check that out. It basically introduces you to the club. We play our first game of the season and all that good stuff. But yes, we've got a lot to catch up on. We've been playing games between last episode and this one, and we've signed and sold some more players. So I guess we've got plenty to do. Let's crack on. So ladies and gents, I've got two more players to introduce you to that have joined the club to try and help us get promoted out of this division. The two players that have left the club were a striker and a right back. They've left for good money. The right back isn't leaving until January, but we're getting about £5 million for him. I was gutted to lose him because he's one for the future, but the board accepted the bid. There was nothing I could do about it, so he is off. And we just got about £400,000 for the striker, Peterson, who was of age, shall we say. He was a bit too old for me, didn't have the pace to keep up, but we have replaced them both. But yes, Vladimir Vasilevich is the first player I need to introduce you to. We have paid all right money for him, not too much to be honest with you. 250k up front, I do believe it is, and the rest is going to be add-ons, my friends. It can go up as high as a million, but as you can see, a central midfielder, very good attributes across the board, can play defensive mid as well if needed. I like the versatility. He's got plenty of room to grow as well, but he's very good at this level already. And the second player I want to introduce you guys to is Artem Bondarenko. He is a striker, a young player, 22 years of age, and he has joined us from Zoya in the Ukraine, I do believe that is. We have paid 600k up front, can go as high as 1.4 million pound though, but he's another one who is very much for the future. He's going to grow with the club. I have previous with signing young players, I like to make my squads nice and youthful as we develop the players as we go along, and I think we're definitely going to be able to do that with this lad. He basically comes in to replace Peterson, and I think he is a good replacement. So there you have it, ladies and gents. A couple more players have joined the club. The transfer window is now closed. We can't sign any more players. As far as the players going out, all the players that are going to go out have done so now. There's another player who's pushing for a move, couldn't shift him because I think we can get good money for him. I'm not just going to take silly, a stupid low amount of money. So we're going to wait until January. If he still wants to leave the club, then we'll try and get rid of him. But yes, it's very much been a rebuilding job. Very early on in our time at Montpellier, a lot of our first team players were not interested in playing for the club, so we've had to move them on. But I do think we've replaced them with quality. And as you can see, our games have been going all right. Three wins and a loss. Only two of them were played in the league. We played a couple of cup games. But yeah, let's get going. We played Tours in the first round of the Coupe de Liga, which is the League Cup in France. And you'll see that Asami and Mujica with the goals in the game put us through to the second round. We then came up against Stade Lavallois in the league. We won by 3-1. A very good win for us. Diop, Mujica, Stokel with the goals for us. They did get one back just before half time. I was a little worried, but they are not the biggest team in the division, and we got a good result. We then moved on to a game against Lens, another one of the favourites, really pushing for a playoff place this season, and we were bitterly disappointed in the game, in my opinion. Diop and Gabriel not having the best games, and we just didn't create a lot of chances. And the one real chance that did present itself in the game presented itself to Lens. It was a free kick from outside the box and just bent it past the goalkeeper. It is what it is. We're not going to win every game. We are going to lose some. It's a very tough league. And next up, we came up in the second round of the French League Cup. And you'll see, we went through on penalties. We didn't miss one. But yeah, it was a heavily rotated team. We were 1-0 all the way to the 89th minute, but they took us straight to penalty. There's no extra time in this competition in France. So that does help, because we are not particularly unfit for the Clermont game. And that is where we are at, and that is what we're going to be playing today. It's a two-game episode. We are going to be playing Clermont and US Créteil Lusatonos. Yes, I'm still terrible with the names, but they're the two games we are going to play, ladies and gents. But so we can crack on, quick look at that league table, and then let's get to it. And well, this is how the league table looks after four games played. Three wins, one loss, and we find ourselves in fifth position. Obviously, we are favourites to win this year, but I do think the favourites tag doesn't help you, because everybody wants to beat you and everyone wants to play well against you. You will see two of the teams that we are playing today are 18th and 19th in the league. I'm hoping, I'm keeping my fingers crossed that we can defeat both of these. To this point, after six games, Obviously, four in the league and two in the cup. I think the tactic's doing all right. I'm going to give it 10 games, see how it's doing. But as you all know, I did speak about it last episode. The three at the back isn't set in stone. Now that we are going up into the higher leagues, we do need to start thinking about other tactics. But for now, it's working. So if it ain't broke, don't fix it. But that does, of course, bring us to our first game of today's episode. And it's going to be Montpellier taking on Clermont in the Domino's Ligue 2. And yes, I'm hoping we can get a very, very good win in the game. You'll see Mujica has hit the ground running. 3 goals for the season already in all competitions. Very good stuff from him. Peter Horney, the best name in football, still yet to grab his first goal. But when he does, I'm sure we will all celebrate in brilliant fashion. But yes, this is the team we're going to go with. De Silva is the man to watch at the moment. He is doing great stuff. I really like the look of him. But let's go. With Picard in goal, we're going to go with Harrell, Penetra and Thailand at the black. We're going to go with De Silva and Stokel on the wings. Marchetti, Matarzo in the midfield. We're going to go Diop behind the strikers. Mujica, Horney up top. Let's do this. So here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Peter Horney does get the game kicked off, and I'm hoping for a positive result in this game. We're at the 20-minute mark, and we're dominating the game, but just nothing of real, nothing to really show you. And the first free kick does go to Clermont, but Bakar, he's going to take that in. And are we going to build from the back and try and get up the other end and score a goal? That's a good throw out to Thailand, into Stockel. We get forward very, very quickly. We've got very good players on the ball in defence, midfield, and up front. De Silva cutting inside. Oh, it's just wide. And that's what I was saying about De Silva. He's the man to watch. Well, at half-time, it's 0-0, and I've got to say, I'm very disappointed in the team. Clermont are really struggling this season, and we should be beating them. And as you can see as well, Sofian Diop has picked up a knock in that first half. I think I'm going to give him a little bit longer, but he may have to be the first substitution we make in this game. Okay, Bakar with the goal kick into Penetra. Coast out wide to Taylan. Being trusted a lot on the football is Taylan in the early stages of our season. Into Stockel. He comes inside. This is nice from him. Into Diop. He's driving forward. That's a lovely ball out wide to Mujica. First time ball, not come off, but Diop with it. Oh, and Diop rolls it in. Even with that fire knock, he scores the goal. And it's 1-0 to Montpellier. Right, ladies and gents. He may have been the scorer of the goal, but I am going to make that substitution because I am obviously very wary of him getting worse. So we're going to bring Holsetta on to play in that position. He plays better in support. I'm going to leave him on attack for now. And we may just drop him in support a bit later on in the game. But for now, we need to be scoring a few more goals. Okay, throw in now. Stockel with it. I don't know why he's come all the way over to this side, but that's a good ball. An unlucky header. Good opportunity. Right, I am going to make another change, ladies and gents. Peter Horney, disappointing again. He's just taken a little while to get used to the league, I think. And let's be completely honest with you guys. Harrell, Marchetti are the only two players in this starting 11 that were here last season. So it just shows you how much we've actually changed at the football team. But Mujica is going to go over to the poacher role. Gabriel is going to come on in place of Peter Horney. Hopefully he can get his goal soon. I don't want him to be a flop because the name just doesn't suggest flop, does it? I'm sorry for the sexual puns. But anyway, yes, we're going to do that. Also, as well, I'm keeping an eye on Stockel. 6.6 isn't great. But obviously, the Marquis, who is the other player who can play on the left wing, isn't as defensive. So, yes, I've got to keep it, you know, tight for now. Right, De Silva, that ball hits the defender, and I'm really hoping they don't build. But can we win the ball back? We're giving them a lot of time here. Are we not going to bother? That's, oh my God, how has he got in? That's a great save from Picard, Jean-Luc Picard, and yes, brilliant stuff. Right, come on now, come on. They've really come back into the game, but that throw-in given away into Mujica. He's driving forward into Matarzo, comes out wide to De Silva. Always a threat, De Silva. Matarzo, go wide, out left. Come on, Marchetti, find him. That's nice. Into Stockel, coming inside. This is nice. Oh, what a run, and he's hit the crossbar. What a goal that would have been. We're literally in the dying embers of the game, and Manuel Stockel has picked up an injury, so we're going to have to bring Marquise on for him, but it does look like it's going to be a 1-0 victory. We have played a lot of injury time, and it doesn't fill me with joy, because that suggests that injury is a bad one, but it's a 1-0 win. We keep on moving on. Okay, ladies and gents, so let's do this second game of today's episode, and we are now on the road. This game comes at a time, though, where we've got quite a few injuries, and some players are out on international duty as well, as you can see. The Stockel injury was pretty bad. 3 weeks we're going to be without him, but good the fact we've got some backup. McKeese can play left side, and obviously we have Usami as well, who probably arguably is better than Stockel, but obviously Stockel's a full-time signing and I'm trying to develop him, so that's why I want to keep playing him as much as possible. But this is the team we're going to go with, and I still think it is a very good team and one good enough to win this game. So let's go with Picard in goal, Harrell, Panetra, Talon at centre back, Da Silva and Usami are going to play on the wings, Marchetti, Matarzo are going to play centre mid. Holsetter is going to come in because Diop isn't the fittest for the game. And we're going to go with Gabriel and Mujica up top. Give Peter Horney a little bit of a rest on the bench. Let's do this. So here we go, ladies and gentlemen. This team are not in the best form. We're heavy, heavy favourites for the game. So I'm hoping we can pick up an easy 3 points. Right, the ball does come out wide though. To them first and foremost. And they're coming inside. And that's good stuff. And that's a great save from Picard. The first real effort goes to the opposition. Okay, we've got a throw in. Da Silva into Mujica. Comes back to Da Silva. Back to Mujica. Lovely ball. Oh, it's claimed by the goalkeeper though. We're yet to have a shot in the game, and we're 14 minutes in already. Harrell takes that down. That's a lovely first touch into Panetra. Marchetti, Panetra again. We're playing some good football. The team has taken to the tactic somewhat, but still work to do. But Mujica's in. Can he score? What a save. Right, free kick. Marchetti with it. It's a brilliant free kick. And Taylor's head. Oh, it's hit the post. Right, throw in. Talon with it into Gabriel, who's come deep to get the ball, but Marchetti now into Talon, into Panetra. I've gone a bit more attacking. I'm hoping we can make something happen. That's been taken down. Oh, what a finish from Alfonso Gabriel. We are 1-0 up. So that's half time and we are dominating the game. I'm going to remain on attacking for a little bit longer in the second half. That it's opened the game up ever so slightly, but we're creating more chances, so I don't want to take the foot off the gas just yet. Rafa Mujica, not quite in the game. I'm hoping we can get him in the second half, though. Right, corner to the opposition now. That's a good header out. Gabriel, that's unlucky. If he'd have taken that down, he could have potentially run at them, but instead they're going to come back at us. Where can we go from here? Can we win this ball back? Just put that pressure on. Don't give them time, and we may be able to win this back and get on the attack. That's a good header out from the defender, and Matarzo with it. He goes wide. Mujica's pace helping him a lot. Mujica! Fourth goal of the season, and that's 2-0. Okay, so we've got to almost the 67th minute, but we've picked up a little bit of a knock here with Da Silva, and I want to try and look after this player. I don't want him to be injured. The only problem is I don't really have a right-sided player that could come on. Matthew can play there. Now, what is he best as? I think I'm going to play him as a wide midfielder on support. He should do a pretty all right job. He's okay. He can dribble the ball. He's not the fastest, but can tackle stuff and look after that right wing. I just don't want to lose Da Silva. He really is an absolute machine for us at the moment. I think I've got to keep my eye on Marchetti as well. Maybe some more subs incoming, but for now, that's all I'm going to do. So, nothing's happened, ladies and gents, since we last met, but I do think it's time for some more substitutions. I think Marchetti does need to come off. We're going to bring Iglio on for him. I think he is right-footed only, yes. Matarzo is, oh, he's right-footed only as well. What's Tarami? He's just right-footed. No, we'll bring Iglio on. It'll be fine. We're going to play him on central midfield on defence. Keep Matarzo as he is. That's all we're going to do, actually, I think. I might save Peter Horney. I might save Diop for a little bit later on, just to see out the clock. But at 2-0 with 15 to go against this team, this should be all she wrote. Right, throw in now. Talon with it. That's into Gabriel. He's done very well with the header. Matarzo into Holsetter. Comes back to Matarzo. Into Holsetter. Oh, what a beautifully worked goal that is. That's 3-0. And Holsetter's first for the club. Throw in. Good stuff from them. Oh, that's a great ball to the back post. And that they have got a goal. That is a consolation. But 3 minutes to go. Please, I don't need a deadly comeback now. Corner. With 4 minutes to go. Please head this out. And Harrell does. But it's coming back at us. They have turned on the afterburners late on in the game. That's ended up in the back of the net. This is worrying. Oh God, Insta highlight. Oh, please don't throw this away. That's great football. Oh, well, that was closer than it needed to be. A couple of set pieces there absolutely undone us, but we are 3-2 winners. The defence needs some work, doesn't it? So, ladies and gents, you join me once again at the fixtures screen, and we've got to talk about next episode. Now, we've got a short international break now, so the players can get themselves fit and hungry for the next game. Obviously, I want to push the series on a little bit, but you will see there's a very interesting game on the horizon for us, and I think that's the one I'm going to bring it back for next episode. So it means I'm going to play three games against Tremblay, Paris FC and Niort, and we're going to come back and do a double episode of Nîmes, who are our rival, our biggest rival, in the division and in the country, and we're going to follow that up with a game against Brest. Both teams are going very well, both in the hunt for a playoff place. So I think that could be a very, very interesting episode. And we get to have a derby day. But before we leave, let's take a quick look at the league table, ladies and gents. We sit top of the pile after six games. Obviously, you will see some of the teams below us have still got to play, so we could drop down a little, but not bad from our opening six. 5 wins, 1 loss. I would like it to be in more convincing style, but we have got a few injuries. And I just think maybe my substitutions are a little unnecessary sometimes, and that costs us. But still, a couple of good wins in today's episode. We're going well. We're favourites to win this division. I'm hoping we can do it, because if not, yeah, I'll get the sack. But what a team. Are you enjoying it? Do you like Montpellier? I love them. So there you have it, my friends. We are done and dusted for another episode of FM19's The Hall of Fame, and it was a fantastic one, my friends. A couple of wins, a few goals scored, and I'm sure you'll all agree that the new signings are settling in very, very well. Do let me know in the comment section below your favourite signing that I've made to this point. I know we're only a couple of episodes into the current season and with our new club, but I do love the feedback. For everybody leaving me player suggestions as well, I really do appreciate them. Please don't think I'm ignoring it. I do scout the players. None of them have been good enough just yet, so it just better players basically is what I'm saying, but yeah, some good suggestions from you guys. But that is it from me today. I will of course be back on Friday with another fantastic episode of this series, but until then, I've been Dan, you've been legends, peace out, saluting you all, have a great day, and I'll see you next time.